Venezuela has had a very rich history of social and political organizing during the Bolivarian Revolution. However, this popular organization has often been ignored or misrepresented by the mainstream media, especially during the recent crisis. A crisis caused, to a large extent, by the US blockade and sanctions, with full support from the Venezuelan opposition, but which has also seen a series of government policies questioned within Chavismo itself. In this context, how are revolutionary organizations surviving? While it's undeniable that popular organization has taken a hit in the past few years, some movements have found a way to resist and even grow stronger. Let's take stock by looking at five examples of revolutionary organization in Venezuela. 1. El Maizal Commune. It is well known that in his final years, Chavez's political project was fully geared towards the construction of the communal state. This idea was captured by his famous battle cry, "Commune or nothing." Chavez was not just referring to a reorganization of the territory, but rather saw the commune as the essential element of grassroots popular power and the basic unit for the construction of socialism. In this sense, El Maizal Commune has been a reference in Venezuela in terms of territorial organization and production, as well as its political commitment to build this communal horizon. The commune brings together 22 communal councils, spanning Portuguesa and Lara states. It currently has 12 productive units engaged in agriculture, cattle rearing, pig farming, and other activities, as well as services such as distributing cooking gas to the community. Another priority has been the political education of the communards. With its internal organization on solid ground, El Maizal Commune has been one of the main promoters of the so-called Communard Union, a platform that looks to bring together communes and other social organizations to build an autonomous base of popular power. The Communard Union means to build a unified planning system for sovereign production and distribution, as well as accumulate strength to influence the direction of the Bolivarian project. 2. Pueblo a Pueblo. Pueblo a Pueblo, or people to people, was the name given to a plan that aims to bring together the city and the countryside. The project sees organized campesinos produce food and deliver it directly to organized urban communities with no intermediaries. Pueblo a Pueblo provides food at fair prices, but it also looks to build food sovereignty by having control over the entire productive chain, from the seed to the final distribution. Since its beginnings, Pueblo a Pueblo has held over 200 weekly food distribution events. The producers are mostly organized in the western state of Trujillo, but 8 other communes and farmsteads in Lara, Portuguesa, and Yaracuy states also take part. The produce is then taken from these farms to Caracas and nearby areas, in a route that takes the name of former guerrilla leader Argimiro Gabaldon. At the other end, several communes, cooperatives, and other social organizations distribute the food that was grown through agroecological practices. To this day, over 400,000 families have taken part in the Pueblo a Pueblo distribution events. 3. Movimiento de Pobladoras y Pobladores. Another organization widely recognized in Venezuela and abroad is the Movimiento de Pobladoras y Pobladores, or the Settlers Movement. Its labor has centered around organizing people for the defense of the land, the city, habitat, and housing, and building a popular and autonomous struggle. The platform brings together 6 major organizations with similar goals. The Urban Land Committees, which look to regulate and transform the urban barrios. The Pioneer Encampments, which propose recovering urban plots to build housing in a self-managed fashion. The Occupiers Movement, with the goal of rescuing abandoned buildings. The Venezuelan Domestic Workers, whose goal is to organize domestic workers and building concierges so as to defend their rights. The Tenants Movement, for the defense of families who rent and have to face speculative prices and unjustified evictions. And finally, the Organized Groups for a Decent Living, which support families at risk in their fight for proper housing. 4. Tinta Violeta. When it comes to feminist struggles in Venezuela, one of the most visible social movements is Tinta Violeta, or purple paint. Its vision is promoting feminism so as to overcome the Venezuelan machista and patriarchal culture as a system that oppresses women, and doing so through organization and education. Ever since being founded in 2012, Tinta Violeta has promoted projects such as Amada, a feminist education program to fight back against the machista mentality that is reflected in cultural and communicational content. It has also been at the forefront of campaigning to legalize abortion and to stop violence against children, as well as organizing support groups for women who have been victims of violence and helping them to navigate the justice system. Furthermore, Tinta Violeta has organized cultural events, such as film festivals, poetry readings, and public education forums to deconstruct patriarchy, while also doing research on the troubling increase in femicides in Venezuela. Tinta Violeta currently has 18 members, but through the years they have always coordinated with a network of other feminist collectives throughout Venezuela. 5. Campesino Struggle Platform. Another organization that has made headlines in Venezuela in recent times has been the National Campesino Struggle Platform. It presents itself as a big family of campesinos coming together around three main goals. 1. Democratizing access to land. 2. Access to seeds, machinery, and other means to produce food. And 3. Improving living conditions in the Venezuelan countryside. The platform has been responsible for several activities to draw the attention of the public, state institutions, and President Maduro to the plight of campesinos. The 2018 Admirable Campesino March was one such example, when dozens of campesinos marched for almost 500 kilometers on foot to denounce evictions, targeted killings, and other issues plaguing the countryside. The organization looks to address and build solidarity around the rescue of unproductive land throughout the country, fighting for the liberation of imprisoned campesinos, producing food wherever possible, and demanding justice for the victims of landowner violence. The revolutionary social and political organizations in Venezuela are far from surrendering in their fight for popular demands and building a better society. Whether in their specific terrain or coordinating in wider struggles, they are all moved by deep revolutionary beliefs, with an unshaken conviction in the project to build socialism. Mired in difficult and perhaps contradictory circumstances, through organization, education, and production, popular movements are the vanguard to defend and deepen the achievements of the Bolivarian Revolution.